Okay, done with your presentation. Let's start with revision of your lesson number one, the living world, adaptation and classification. We have already learned this, yes, and I'm just going to give a quick review of this lesson and you have to answer all of my questions, okay? So let's start. What we have seen in this lesson that there is a great variety of plants and animals found on our earth, okay? Some animals are unicellular and some are multicellular. Some are vertebrates and some are invertebrates also, okay? Some animals are aquatic, terrestrial, some are amphibian, reptilian, aerial. So we are distributing animals like this according to our observation, okay? So what is adaptation? Gradual changes occur in the body part and also in the behavior of organism which help them to adjust to their surrounding. Such changes are called adaptation. Adaptation actually includes some changes which are causes in the behavior of organism, which takes place in the behavior of organism because they are trying to adjust to their surrounding. Okay. Next, we have learned about the adaptation in aquatic animals. Aquatic plants, sorry. For adapting into the aquatic condition, what the aquatic plant want have to do? What their body is constructed, okay? How their body is constructed for getting adapted in the aquatic environment? Their stems are submerged while leaves and flowers float on the surface, okay? And in some cases, entire body of that plant is floating on the surface of water, okay? And their roots are not anchored in the soil. So, for their leaves to remain fresh and do not get rotten, there is a waxy layer present on the surface of that plant's leaves, okay? And their leaves of some aquatic plants are thin and slender, like a ribbon. Because of this shape, they can withstand the fast current of the water. There are some air spaces in the stem and petioles of aquatic animals, and these air spaces or vacuoles are useful for them to float on a water. Okay, some examples were lotus, yes, and the lotus stalk. You can see there are some vacuoles in the stem. Next, we have seen adaptation in desert plant. Okay, desert plants are either leafless or their leaves are like small needle. Okay, small needle, or have modified into the thorns like cactus. As a result, what happens? They lose a very little water by the evaporation, and they need to store this water. Okay. And because they are storing the water, their leaves are fleshy. Their leaves can be seen fleshy. Their stems are also green, and these help them to do the photosynthesis for requirement to fulfill the requirement of their food. They also have a thick layer of waxy substance on the stem of this plant. Okay, next is we have seen the adaptation in plants of snowy region. How there is a very heavy snowfall and extreme cold. Okay, so shape of these plants are conical. Because of this conical shape, it helps to prevent the snow from accumulating on the trees, and the thick bark helps the tree to withstand the cold. Okay. Then we have seen the adaptation in plants of forest region. Forest region madhe ka asta, there is also competition between these plants for getting the sunlight. And hence, because of this adaptation, these trees are growing tall and tall to get the sunlights. And climbers and vines also grow on to their height to get their support. Okay. Next, we have seen the adaptation in the grassland plants. What Yes, diverse types of bushes and grasses are found in grassland, and the fibrous roots of these plants prevents the erosion of soil and hence helping to maintain the balance of our biodiversity or ecosystem of our environment. These plants are dense because animals like tiger, elephant, and deer can remain hidden in these grasses. Okay. Next, we have seen adaptation for ingestion of food in plants. Some plants are parasitic. Some plants like dodder are parasitic. The plant's body of dodder is consists of wire-like stem. Okay, wire-like stem, which is yellow in color. As it is leafless, they do not have leaf. It could not perform photosynthesis. Okay, so they have the sucking roots for absorbing nutrients from the host plant. And what they do, they penetrate these roots into the conducting vessel and absorb the water and food from the host plant. Okay, as we know that fungi also do not have the chlorophyll, and they also cannot perform photosynthesis, so they can obtain their food from the starchy foodstuffs in our house. Okay, plants need nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium for growth, and plants that grow in soil which is deficient in nitrogen, like Drosera, Venus flytrap, pitcher plant, they fulfill their need of nitrogen by consuming the insects. Okay, we know that symbiotically plants can get the nitrogen from the soil. There is another method also, like the lightning. Yes, the environment atmospheric method. But what about the plants which are situated in the soil which is nitrogenless, which do not have any type of nitrogen? These plants fulfill their need of nitrogen by consuming the insects. Okay, they are insect eaters, insectivorous. Next, adaptation in animals. Adaptation in animals, we have learned. See, fishes have scales on the skin and fins on the body. Their body tapers towards the both ends like a spindle. Why is this so? Because they have they have air bladder within the body. Their body is shaped like that so that they can survive in the water and they can float in the water. Next, the frog and duck have the web toes, and their legs perform the function of oar. Okay. Water flows off the waxy feather. They have these birds have the duck have waxy feathers. There is a wax layer on the feather of the duck, so the water flows from that. Okay, webbed toes, slippery smoothie skin, and triangular head help frogs to swim easily through water. They can live on land as well as in water due to their ability to breathe through the skin in water and using the nose and lungs on the land. See why a frog is called as amphibian, why it can live in water and on the land also, because in the water it can breathe through the skin, and on the land it can breathe through the nose and lungs. Okay, then adaptation in forest and grassland animals. What we have learned in this, a tiger-like animal have the padded paws. This enable them to silently stalk their prey and capture it very easily. Eyes of this predatory carnivorous are located in the front of their head so that it can help them to spot their prey from a very long distance. Okay. Next, about herbivorous. Herbivorous eyes are situated below the forehead on either side of the head. Okay, this gives them a wide angle vision, which is very positive feature of them, so that they can protect them themselves from the predator. Their legs are also long and tapering with strong hooves, because of which they can run very fast, like taking a long leaps. Also, the deer, black box have the colors that merge with their surrounding, and they can easily can be hide from the predators. Okay, adaptation in the desert animals. See, adaptation in desert animals, what we have seen that we all know that there is a scarcity of water in desert. Hence, desert animals have a thick skin to prevent the loss of water which is present in the body. Okay, they have the thick skin so that the water loss should not take place. They also have flat and cushioned soles at their legs. Their nostrils are protected by the fold of skin so that the dust could not get inside the nostrils or the nose. Eyelashes are long and thick to prevent eyes from the dusting. Rat, snake, spider, lizard in desert live in deep burrows during the daytime so that they can be safe from the scratching heat or the scarcity of water, and they become active at night. As you know, there is a very low temperature at night in desert places. Okay, next, adaptation in animal of snowy region. How snowy region animals are adapted to their environment? See, they have given us images or names of some animals like yak, polar bear, white fox, silver fox, mountain goat, Siberian husky dog, and snow leopard. These are some snowy region. These are some animals which can be found in the snowy region. Okay, so they have a white or silver body color, long and thick hair on the skin. It is the main typical character of this animal. Because of this, they can be saved from the very cold environment which is present, very cold climate which is present over there in a snowy region. Okay, their hairs grows very thick in the winter season so that their can be protected from the cold environment. Next, adaptation in aerial animals. Which are the aerial animals? Birds. Okay, so their body is spindle shaped. How their body is adapted to their environment? Their body is spindle shaped, because of which it also minimizes the resistance of air while flying. They have the hollow bones and body. Their body is covered with feathers, and their forelegs are modified into the wings so that these features make their body light in weight, and they can easily fly in the air. Okay. With the birds, insect can also fly in the air. Insects have light and wet body and tapers at both the ends. They can also fly with two pairs of wings and walk with six stick-like legs. Adaptation in reptiles. Okay. The reptile animals like lizard, garden lizard, crocodile use their muscle for creeping. Okay, they show adaptation in the skin, soles of feet, body color, etc. Now, adaptation for food in animals. For getting their food, every animal is dependent on another, according to which they are classified as herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous. Okay. Adaptation for blending with surrounding. See, we can easily spotify the colorful butterflies, lizard, and grasshopper. They get camouflaged amidst grasses, parts of plants like stem, leaves, flowers, etc. That is because their colors blend with those of their surrounding. Changes that takes place in the various organ and life process of each and every organism that enable them to live, feed, reproduce, and perpetuate themselves and protect themselves from their enemies in specific surrounding डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द हैबिटेट एंड इट्स जियोग्राफिकल कंडीशन, दीज आर ऑल टुगेदर कॉल्ड एज अडाप्टेशन. ओके, नेक्स्ट वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द डार्विन थ्योरी ऑफ इवोल्यूशन. यस, सो व्हाट वी हैव लर्न इन दिस, एंड इफ एन ऑर्गेनिज्म इज बॉर्न विद न्यू बेनिफिशियल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक एंड इज एबल टू सर्वाइव, द चेंज इज प्रिजर्व इन द नेक्स्ट जनरेशन ऑल्सो. ओके, देन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म, how they are classified, they require the classification, and this is called as the hierarchy of classification. So by they are classified by using a method, binomial nomenclature, which was founded by Carl Linnaeus. What was this binomial nomenclature? Everything has two names. First, the common name which we actually pronounce, which we actually call by saying that thing, and the second name is the scientific name. Okay, this includes the binomial nomenclature. Understood? We have revised the whole lesson in 15 minutes. Have you understood it very clearly? Have you recalled? Yes, the understood word should not be there. Have you recalled? I have already taught you very clearly, very slowly we have learned this. Okay, so shall we move to the question answer now? Okay, yes, for the okay, for the match the following, you have to write the option only. Okay, ABCD you can write. Lotus, flower and leaves attract insect, hostorial roots for absorption of food, adapted to live in desert, adapted to live in water. Yes, it's D, adapted to live in water. Okay. Aloe vera. Yes, adapted to live in desert. Cascata, yes, Cascata, hostorial roots for absorption of food, and Venus flytrap, yes, flowers and leaves attract insect. It is an insectivore. Okay, why is the camel called the sheep of the desert? Yes, Anagha.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
The skin of camel is thick. The legs are long with cushioned soles. There is a fold of skin for protection of nostrils. The eyelashes are long and thick, and thus they protect the eyes. Fat is stored in its hump, due to which it can survive for a long time without water. Due to all of such adaptations, camel becomes most suitable to walk in the desert. Thus, it is used as means of transport and is called sheep of the desert.
Very nicely explained. Good. How can the plants like cactus and acacia live in deserts with scarce water? Yes, Aditi.
Hello.
Yes.
Desert plants like cactus and acacia are either leafless, or their leaves are like small needles or turns into thorns. As a result, they lose very little water by evaporation. The stem stores water of food and is therefore fleshy. The stem are green as they perform photosynthesis in the absence of leaves. Their roots penetrate in deep into the soil in search of water. There is a thick layer of waxy substance on the stem of these plants.
Yes. Next, What is the interrelationship between adaptation of organism and their surrounding? What is the interrelationship between adaptation of organism and their surrounding? Yes, Deepika.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
We cannot easily spot colorful butterflies, lizards, and grasshoppers. They get camouflaged amidst grasses, parts of plants like stem, leaves, flowers, etc. That is because their colors blend with the those of their surroundings.
Yes, any other adaptation? You can give any example for this. Just they have asking interrelationship. Yes, Sanjana, will you? Okay. How are the organisms classified? How are the organisms classified? Yes, Maika.
And classify according to their characters. For this, the detailed study of this organism is done based on the basic similarities and difference. The organisms are classified into groups and subgroups.
Hierarchy
is formed, and depending upon these features, in this way the organisms and place into suitable groups and classification of achieve.
Okay, yes, put off your mic. Anyone else with this answer? How are organisms classified? Yes, Aditi.
Hello.
Yes.
After the detailed study of organisms, they are classified according to their similarities and differences. A hierarchy is formed. Hierarchy is formed in the classification that starts with kingdom Animalia and or kingdom Plantae. Further groups and subgroups are formed.
Okay. Question number four. Read each of the following statements. Write a paragraph about adaptation with reference to each statement. What you have to do? This statement is related to every type of adaptation. First is related to desert adaptation, then a grassland adaptation. Yes, like this. So, will you answer this question? Should I ask you? Okay, yes. So, first is, there is extreme heat in deserts. There is extreme heat in deserts. You have to tell a paragraph related to this type of adaptation. Yes. Yes, Sanjana. What happened? She writes her name in the chat box for answer, and every time I ask, she left. Yes, Sanjana. Yes, so will you answer now? Yes, yes, sure. You, I'm asking to you only. Yes, Sanjana, please.
Ma'am?
Yes.
The living organisms residing in extreme heat of desert show appropriate adaptations in their structure of body and their life process. Camels show many adaptations like modified legs, eyes, nose, and the hump. On the back, rats, snakes, स्पाइडर एंड लिजार्ड्स एस्केप द हीट ऑफ द सन बाय रिमेनिंग इनसाइड दे डीप बोरोज ड्यूरिंग डे टाइम. प्लांट्स लाइक डिफरेंट स्पेसिक ऑफ कैक्टी हैव स्पेसिकल मॉडिफाइड बॉडी स्ट्रक्चर विथ विच दे सर्वाइव इन द एक्सट्रीम हीट टू.
यस. नेक्स्ट, ग्रासलैंड आर लश ग्रीन. Grasslands are lush green. What adaptation is related to this? Yes, Deepika?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Diverse types of bushes and grasses are found in the grasslands. Fibrous roots of grasses prevent soil erosion. Forests in the equatorial region are dense. Animals like tiger, elephants and deer can remain hidden in these grasses. However, grasses in cold regions are very short. Animals like the rabbit are found in such grasses. Vast meadows are found in hilly areas as well as plains.
Yes, good. See, you said animal and one is barking behind you. Yes? Okay, see. Insects are found in large numbers. Insects are found in large numbers. Yes? Yes, Anaga.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Insects adapt to any kind of habitat. Some insects can fly. They have adaptations like light bodies to pairs of wings which help them in flying. Some insects are also aquatic. Some stay near water bodies. Some are in deserts too. Many have ability to camouflage with environment and thus they escape the attention of predators. They can produce in large numbers due to all of such adaptations. Insects are found in large numbers.
Yes, good. Next is, we hide. We hide. Who will tell this? Yes, I want new name. Yes, Ameya, will you? Ameya, you have raised your hand. You want to answer this question? Okay, Sanjana.
Some of those hide are weak organisms. In order to seek protection of enemies, they hide in their habitats. Coloration of their body mixes with the surroundings, and thus enemy do not see these hiding creatures. Some of them hide also for catching prey.
Yes. Okay. Next is, we have long ears. We have long ears. Yes, Prathamesh?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Long ears are seen in herbivores. They have to be alert from the attack of predators. Carnivores, they can move their ears to locate the approaching prey. In the case of such danger, they run away in the herd. Having long ears is adaptation to escape from enemies.
Yes. Okay, some of you have your FCC class after this, right? Yes. Okay. Okay, question number 3. Who is lying? Cockroach. I have 5 legs. Yes? Yes, Aditi?
cockroach is lying because cockroach has six legs.
Yes. Lying. You have to say lying. Okay. Hen. My toes are webbed. Hen. My toes are webbed. Yes, Sanjana.
Hen is lying. Its toes are not webbed.
Cactus. My fleshy green part is a leaf. Yes, Pradyumna.
My fleshy green part is a stem. Cactus is lying.
Okay, question number two. Read the paragraph and answer the following question. I am going to read the paragraph first. Okay, then you have to answer my question. I'm penguin. I'm not a penguin. I'm reading just a paragraph. Okay. I'm a penguin. I live in polar region covered by snow. My abdomen is white. My skin is thick with a layer of fat underneath. My body is spindle shaped. My wings are small. My toes are webbed. We live in flocks. One. Why is my skin white and thick, and why is there a thick layer of fat underneath? We'll answer this question. Yes, Ameya, please make clear. You are raising your hand. You want to answer this question?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, please.
Penguins have white skin because to hide in snow, and thick skin to prevent it from cold.
Yes. And what about that fat underneath? Yes, anyone? Yes, Pradyumna?
Penguins have white skin because they hide in snow, and they have thick layer of fat underneath because they feel warm. They protect from the snow.
Okay. Next is, why do we live in flocks sticking close to each other? Yes, Anaga.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
By staying in a flock, one is protected against the attack from predator. It becomes easier for parental care. Also, by sticking to each other, the body heat is not lost to the surroundings.
Okay. Which geographical region do I inhabit? Why? Yes, Deepika?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Penguin stays in polar region, especially in Antarctica region. There is abundant food available for penguins, and thus they are seen here.
Okay. Which adaptation should you have to enable you to live permanently in the polar region? Why? Yes, Prathamesh?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
In order to permanently inhabit in the polar region, the body should be adapted to all temperatures. There should be thick layer of fat and thin skin to protect the body. Availability to regular body temperature should be extremely good for the survival.
Okay, anyone else? Anyone else? Okay, Deepika.
Ma'am?
Yes.
In order to permanently inhabit in polar region, the body should be adapted to cold temperature. The ability to regulate body temperature should be extremely good for survival.
Yes. But what adaptation you will do in your body? What adaptation is required there? You should have. Yes, Anagha.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
In order to permanently inhabit in the polar region, the body should be adapted to cold temperature. There should be thick layer of fat and thick skin to protect the body. The ability to regulate body temperature should be extremely good for the survival.
Yes. Yes, you all are telling the same answer. It is right. But I just wanted to add something like what adaptations you will do. Okay, like your body hair should be very thick. Okay, your body's color should be like matching to the polar region like this. Okay, just add that. Okay, so we have completed your lesson number one with revision very clearly. Have you understood it? Tell me. Okay, let me ask you the questions from inside. What is adaptation? What is adaptation? Yes. Prathamesh?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Gradual changes occur in the body parts and also in the behavior of organisms, which help them to adjust their surroundings. Such changes are called adaptation.
Yes. Aditi, tell me about the aquatic adaptation. How aquatic plants' body is adapted to their environment? What changes they have, how the body
हेलो,
is adapted to the aquatic environment? Yes.
हेलो, हेलो,
Yes.
सम ऑफ
Yes, you are
एक्वाटिक
audible,
प्लांट,
please.
सम ऑफ द एक्वाटिक प्लांट्स आर फॉर्मली रूटेड इन द सॉइल एट द बॉटम ऑफ द वाटर बॉडीज. देयर स्टीम्स आर
Submerged.
समर्स वाइल लीव्स एंड फ्लावर्स फ्लोट ऑफ द सरफेस. हाउएवर सम प्लांट्स आर एंटरली अफ्लोट. देयर रूट्स आर नॉट एंचोर्ड इन द सॉइल,
एंकर्ड.
एंकर्ड इन द सॉइल. द सरफेस ऑफ लीव्स एंड The surface of leaves and stems of many aquatic plants are covered with a waxy layer. Leaves of some aquatic plants are thin and slender like a ribbon. This shape helps them to withstand fast current of water. Air spaces in stem and petioles of aquatic plants are
Petiole.
in petioles of aquatic plants are useful for floating in water.
Okay. The desert's plants' leaves are modified into thorns. Why is this so? Why the leaves of the desert plants are modified into thorns? For what purpose they are modified into thorns? Yes, Deepika?
Ma'am,
Yes.
desert plants either leafless or their leaves are like small needles or have been modified into thorns. As a result, they lose very little water by evaporation.
Yes. How the plants in the snowy region are adapted to their environment? How the plants in snowy region are adapted to their environment? Yes, anyone else? Okay, Prathamesh, yes.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Plants of snowy region mainly include conifers like deodar and pine. These are conical in shape due to the sloping branches in the heavy snowfall and extreme cold in this region. Their conical shape prevents the snow from accumulating on the trees, and the thick bark helps the tree to withstand the cold.
Okay, good. Why the trees in the forest region go very tall? Why the trees in the forest region grows very tall? What is the reason behind that? Yes, Mahika?
Themselves for sunlight, hence the tree grow.
Will you speak a little louder?
Okay. Tree grow tall to get sunlight, and climbers and vines grow to a great height with the support of trees.
Okay. For getting the sunlight, okay. Why the forests in the equatorial region are dense? Why the forest in the equatorial region are dense? Yes? No one? What happened? Okay, Deepika?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Diverse types of bushes and grasses are found in the grasslands. Fibrous roots of grasses prevent soil erosion. Forests in the equatorial regions are dense.
But why they are dense? Because the animals like tiger, elephants and deer can remain hidden in these grasses. Okay? Yes, understood everyone? का गर्दी असते, का दाटी असते त्या झाडांची? कारण हे प्राणी इजीली त्यामध्ये लपू शकतात म्हणून. हाउ द सकिंग रूट्स perform their function of absorbing nutrients from the host plant? Yes? How the sucking roots perform their function of taking food or absorbing nutrients from the host plant? What they do for that? Yes? Yes, Deepika?
Ma'am?
Yes?
The plant body of dodder consists of yellow wire-like stems. It is leafless and cannot perform photosynthesis. However, it has hostorial sucking roots of absorbing nutrients from the host plant.
I am asking how they perform this function of absorbing nutrients from the host plant.
Their roots penetrate up to the conducting vessels of the host plant to absorb water and food.
Yes, that was I expecting. From what foodstuff a fungi can obtain their food? From what types of foodstuff a fungi can obtain their food? Yes. Sangha. Yes, Mahika.
They obtain food from starchy foodstuffs like bakri and bread.
Yes, good. Okay, how a frog can live in water and on land also? How a frog is able to live on land and in water also? Yes, Aditi?
Hello?
Yes.
They can live on land as well as water due to their ability to breathe through the skin in water and using the nose and lungs on land.
Okay. Pradyumna, how carnivorous animals are adapted to their environment? What changes have made in their body to get adapted to their environment? Yes, Pradyumna.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Carnivorous animals like wild dog, fox, tiger, and lion, they capture their prey.
How?
And they eat that prey. They have very sharp teeth and claws.
Okay. And what about the herbivorous one? Yes, anyone? How the herbivorous animals are adapted to their environment? Kon sangnar? Yes. Okay. Yes, Deepika.
Ma'am?
Yes.
The eyes of herbivores are below the forehead, on either side of the head. This gives them wide-angle vision, which helps to protect them from predators. Their legs are long and tapering with strong hooves, which enables them to run fast, taking long leaps. Their long and freely moving ears can receive sounds from long distance and different directions.
Okay. Yes, so we have completed revision of our lesson number 1, okay? Till we reach the lesson number 4, we are not going to start lesson number 5, okay? First, we will revise whatever we have learned in the first 4 lessons and then we will go to the 5th one. Yes, is it okay for you? As we are going, this method is, yes, favorable with you. It is okay? Yes? Okay, thank you. So, we are going to stop over here for today as some of you are having your FCC class at 9, okay? Yes? So, we'll meet in the next lecture. Till then, bye-bye everyone.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.